Boom! Welcome, welcome. Good morning. Welcome to Mark's Tasty Chong. Just getting ready. Getting the old white coat on. I've got my knives sharpened. We've got no viewers yet. Everybody still sleeping? No? Good morning, good morning. Richard. Right, gloves are on, knives are sharpened. I just need to sort out. I've lost my container for my rubbish. There's always a plan. There's one thing that always left over in my things is a bit of spice. Love a bit of spice. Right, what I am going to do is I'm going to take the phone. Excuse the look up my nostrils. And we are going to pop you in the phone holder. Make sure it does not. So, hopefully, yes indeed, you can see. Right, we've got several roasts, nowhere near as big as last week. These are tiny in comparison. But the nice thing is they've all got nice cover on them. By cover I mean nice fat. They don't even look like they need much trimming, to be fair. Not massive. They just need a little bit of trimming. So a little bit there. That's nice hard fat there. I'm not going to take that off. These are, in effect, the bottom rounds, aren't they? Because you got your top round and your bottom round. See these bits here? We're going to take that bit off. But I'm going to leave this nice yellow fat here. Nice yellow fat. Beautiful, beautiful. Right, let's take the saboteur. Saboteur. And just go straight down. Oh, man. You want to see the marbling in this? Jeez, that's going to be the best one yet. I haven't had one like this for quite some time. If you're ordering fatty this week, you're in for a massive treat. This knife just doesn't feel as sharp. Let's try the other one. Yeah, that feels a bit sharper. I have sharpened them. That is just a piece of fat on the end. And Alexa, play. Bit of music. Here we go. Nice. Probably my video will be muted in several countries. Oh well. Look at the marbling in this. Absolutely beautiful. Alexa, volume 6. So if I have it too loud, they're going to block my video. So all I've done is literally, I mean, look at that. That is absolutely beautiful. Beautiful marbling in there. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Look at that. Absolutely beautiful. Gets less and less the further back you go, but there's still a little bit of marbling in there. But that's how quickly these roasts are going to get sliced up. That's one down already. He's a UK 8119 EC. That's the approval code on the bag. Didn't actually say where it's from. Well, we've got another one very similar. Where is my knife sharpener? Because I want to use my saboteur. I like using this knife. And if it's not sharp, I'm not happy. So again, we got another bottom round. These are obviously the... There's a little bit of trimming required, but nothing like my usual amount. My waste will be very minimal this week. I'm gonna leave that, it's all nice fat. But and to leave all this as well when that dries. So this is somehow got ripped in there. You know what? It's good to go. Let's go. Oh, that's better. Now I've sharpened it. I can feel the difference. Now really, I should have been doing some more chili bites and original bites, but don't think I'm going to get to do any this week because can't really make them out of this. I like the lean. So when you're cutting into the fat, you can feel it. It's a bit tatty down there. There's some nice fat on these. Beautiful fat. To be fair, all of them have got nice fat on today. Probably the weekend I need all the blooming lean stuff. Because I did do some midweek as well. Didn't go live. I just did about four big roasts on, was it Tuesday night, Wednesday night? Just look at the marbling. Absolutely beautiful. Nice, good fat on there, good fat on there. You get little bits, and all those little bits go in. Rubbish. Right, I think there's one more. Oh no, there's still two more of these with the yellow fat on. Okay, but I love a bit of AC/DC on a Saturday morning. It is still morning. So this one requires again very minimal trimming. They've left a little piece of sinew on the side here. Grab, pull. Not going to be too pedantic. See, this is not the greatest. So this will be one of those ones. Probably get a good amount of lean off this. Got a little bit of fat on there, but trying to get all this slippery stuff off. That's good stuff there. Anything that feels like it wants to come off, take it off. See, I'm actually happy with that. I'm fine with that. So I'm going to put this in that position. Just going to trim that end piece off. It'll still get dried. And try to square this off a bit. Feel it is nice and tender. If you can, go into the bottom, use the weight of your shoulders to push down, and your blade should just slide all the way through and down. Don't be afraid of it. When you're afraid, you're going to end up hurting yourself. Respect it, but don't be afraid of it. Always respect the blade, especially since they are razor sharp. So, see these little faults? You don't want to do that in Africa. Well, thankfully we are not in Africa. We don't have a problem with flies. I am basically done, but that is relatively lean. Still a little bit of cover on it. Move the knife out of the way and grab the next one. Charming. So this is how it comes. Show you that. Vacuum sealed for freshness. Even all the bags that I do cut off these, they all get washed at the end as well. Washed and bagged. See, there's no lot of, might need to trim that little bit off there. Again, these are the bottom, it's the bottom round. A little bit of meat flew up on the wall there. Funny. Right, let's flick this over. Oh, got some really nice hard fat here. But here's my, what I call the skirt. Remember, I've said it a number of times. Usually the soft part. And it's very, very soft. Turns your Friday into what day? I'd say turn your Friday into Friday. So, those of you watching from the UK, I hope you remembered it was Mother's, well, it is Mother's Day tomorrow. And if your mom is here, I know that some of them are getting some really good biltong for Mother's Day, because I did them myself. I've had a few Mother's Day orders, quite a few. Right, I'm using my old Masterclass blade here, just because it hasn't had a slice yet. I like the newly sharpened blades. I love how it just slides in, slides through. This blade isn't as comfortable. The handle is a little bit slippy for me. I think I could be quite a a good critic with knives. See, that for me, it's just not doing what I want it to do. My ideal one is this. I know I should be really using like my thumb on there, gives more control, I suppose. That end piece is almost all fat. But you know what? I'm not wasting it. My roast is hanging off the table here, so let's move it forward a bit. So we're ready. How many in we've done? Four, I think. This is the fourth one. It's going to be quick this morning. And I've got 30 kgs of drovors I need to hang as well. I did it last night. It's got to go in. This will all get marinated now and go in this evening. Be ready Monday evening. I do love that. That just looks like a really nice steak. Could just as easily go on the braai, that one. Ooh, yeah. Right. Slightly different beef now. This is Angus. This is some Angus. Where's this from? Is it Irish? It is. It's from Ireland. I do like the Irish. I love the Irish. But these come at a price because they aren't trimmed. So right, we got a few out of today's batch that I didn't need much trimming. Again, when you're slicing this way, which you shouldn't be, always be careful. Jeez, took a bit too much meat off of that one. If you see any sinew, take it off. So those of you that do make your own biltong, is it? I never get really much feedback as to whether you're using some of my method or all of my method. Do you think these videos are helpful? I don't publish every week on YouTube, but probably today's will be. So, got a nice silver off this one. Gets dried up for the hounds. Just a bit of fat off the side there that I'm trimming off. Don't want to take too much off because we want it. Okay, I think we're good on that side. How are we doing on this side? I like it. I feel that, it's nice. If you feel it's firm, it's good. I am gonna trim this side up a little bit because there's a bit of sloppiness here. What is wrong with these knives? Didn't sharpen them properly.
Yeah.
I've got two different types of knife sharpeners, and I think if I use both types, they don't sharpen it at the same angle, which is why they don't feel as sharp, because I used a different one today. Just giving a different edge, so to speak. Yeah, I'm going to leave that bit. It's good to go. Let's just trim this up. Get a nice flat edge. Your left side pushed up firm, just stops it from falling over. These will be nice, really nice. A little bit thick, that one on the end, so woo, nearly went on the floor. It would have been catastrophe. See this end bit here? You just chop that off, that goes in. Oh, that was a bit thin. Now these didn't go through very well. That one did. That one did. Sorted. Bob's your auntie. Any little bits on your board, get rid of them. Really haven't got a lot of scrap today, which is good.
It is good.
Right, I've only got two left. Very much like that last one. Irish Angus. Again, I like to rinse them off. Anything they're caught in that plastic bag gets washed away. So you can clearly see when I put this on its back that there is some significant trimming to do. Snotty stuff. Okay, what do we got here? Just try and keep this as good as I can. Try not to take too much off. It's gone a little bit over the top over there. Huh? Okay, let's turn it on its side. Sinew here. What's happened there? Some more. Oh! Okay. Nice piece of sinew there on the side. Come on, can't grab that piece. Always watch your fingers. could almost shave with this. See that soft skin? That's on the other side. Let's go over. See? Try and grab that. Move with it. Always try and go just under the skin. I'm pulling up and using the blade to push. I'm gonna leave that. Let's trim this side. If it's very, very, very thin, really, you don't, once this is dried, you don't really even, you can hardly see that. You don't even taste it. It's very thin. I'm gonna leave the rest. It's fine. It's good. What I might do is actually take this piece with the fat and where are we? Let's use the Nego. I'm gonna go underneath this fat and I'm taking it in one hit. Like that. Even that end bit. It's going in. Even this one didn't sharpen properly. It's quite surprising. Right, then we're gonna move it. See, this one has got the two muscles here. There's your top round and kind of a middle round. To try and keep a whole bunch of lean because I want to do some more chili bites with them. So let's have another container here, shall we? Let's put that there as well. I am going to move my blades over there. I've been trying not to because if my phone falls, breaks. Now we're getting to the part where it's joined here, so you are going to get a little bit of fat. We go into the fatty part. It's nice and lean. I don't know, I've got to decide yet if I am making chili bites. I have got some in stock. Might just do some next week. Because I need lean as well. Sod's law. My supplier gives me fatty when I need lean and lean when I need fatty. It's just how it works out. Ugh. Didn't go very straight there. See, even these little pieces, they go into the pile. They go into the biltong pile. This will go in the bites pile. Very lean. Bites. Well, I'll be damned. Got one more. Just one more. Very, very quick this morning. Very quick. Another Irish. Nice thing is the water is ice cold. Cleaning that, some of it came off. Some of the sloppy stuff. This is disgusting stuff. Didn't trim this one off at all. That's just blood. Congealed blood. Trying to be as good as I can be. See, there's always a bit of a dent here, so it's quite difficult sometimes to catch that whole silver side without taking meat with it. There's always going to be some. That's a good piece off. And you got this just solid bit of fat on there. That's gotta go. Let's just clean this up. This is the farmer in me, cutting meat. I've been doing it quite a bit with my dad. I don't think my dad particularly liked doing it, which ended up with a lot of backache, just like I do, but I got a lot of satisfaction doing it. See this on the side here? Gotta go. Trim it up. Look at that, like a little tree. Okay, let's flick it over. What have we got? We've got some decent fat on here. Nice fat. I just trim up that bottom a little bit. It's a bit sloppy down here. I like it. All right, let's